Hey, and what is happening, guys? Yankee here. We're back for some more Let's Play Pokemon Crystal. In the last part, we sailed on over on the SS Aqua and arrived in our first town of the Kanto region, Vermilion City. And right now, we're about to take on our first gym leader who resides in Vermilion City. So, redundancy. But anyway, I just wanted to show off what was right up the, where we exited the port. And let's just talk to this portly fellow over here. Skilled trainers gather in Kanto, gym leaders are especially strong. They won't be easy to defeat. Well, I already kind of knew that from gym leaders I defeated in the last region. And Snorlax is snoring peacefully. Okay, unlike Red and Blue, Snorlax is full-blown life-size in this. He's like so huge, like compared to the other Pokemon who are just our size, Snorlax is just a giant. I don't know why they just fixed his sprite and not anyone else's in the Pokemon universe, but I guess they really wanted to make Snorlax pop, and he definitely fills the room now, but anyway, what's over here? My Pokemon is preparing the land for construction, but I have no money to start the project. Aw, old man, unfortunately Kickstarter won't be made until 10 years later after this game is made. Ah, tough break there, lad. And we see this Machop, goo ga ga! Whoa, this baby's angry. A Machop is growling while stomping the ground flat. Oh, he's making his land. I love how it's like a little joke from the first game, like he's still doing that. Jeez, Vermilion City, the port of exquisite sunsets. Ah, I can definitely, this is definitely a town you would go to out east on the weekend, just like, I'm from Long Island, so we go to the Hamptons and like Montauk and all that, so yeah, this is basically my version of that. So let's just cut down this tree right here and make our way to the gym. And I just wanted to show off who I substituted out. Obviously, I'm going to lead with Gar, the ground-type Pokemon, because this is an electric-type gym, and everyone knows the gym leader here, but yeah, I took out Glovecrime, the water Pokemon, because obviously he's going to be weak, and this is the Pokemon I was going to actually add to my team, but I backed out at the last second, Skarmory. Yes, I'm using it as my cut sleeve and fly sleeve, even though Crobat knows fly now, but yep, I nicknamed it Songbird because obvious Bioshock Infinite reference. What a great game, great story, great game, ugh. So anyway, the Pokemon Gym, Lieutenant Surge, Lightning American. In America! Okay. I know any America jokes I can make, but let's just go on in and take on Guile, I mean. Lieutenant Surge, but here we go! Yo, champ in making! You lucked out this time. Lieutenant Surge is very cautious. He has traps set all over the gym. But the traps aren't active right now. You'll have no problem getting to Lieutenant Surge. Wow, Game Freak, you really thought we were that dumb we wouldn't figure out this puzzle. I guess enough people had that much trouble and they just took out the puzzle altogether. Guess they couldn't look inside of a trash can. But anyway, let's take on his disciples. I'm going to take you down. Prepare to be shocked. Let me guess, this guy a guitarist, but nope, we have a new battle theme. He is a juggler, okay. But yes, the new battle theme of the Kanto region. And I actually prefer it over the Johto region because I obviously have a bias toward Red and Blue. And it's nice to hear that old theme remixed right here. And is this guy really gonna have four electrodes because he's a juggler? He has to have ball Pokemon, really? We're going that route? But anyway. Well, let's just finish it with Boomerang four times in a row. But yeah, I just like to imagine this juggler, like, is he juggle the electrodes? Like, you know how hard that would be? This guy's actually a really skilled juggler if he can handle that, because Voltorbs are probably the size of a basketball. Electrodes are like a beach ball size, even bigger than that, so how's this guy actually doing? I like to imagine like jugglers have a little game, like a little Russian roulette game, but Russian electrode, but they all just toss the electrode up in the air and one out of the four electrodes they juggle, you self-destruct and that's how it ends. Very twisted Pokemon games in this universe, but yeah, he'll have two more electrodes. But yeah, I might as well talk about Lieutenant Surge, everyone's favorite gym leader of the original Pokemon games because he is the Lightning American. And he obviously started off some rumors and conspiracies about Pokemon War and all that. It raises two questions. Why is there an American in this universe? Because everything's really Japanese and stuff, so it's even set in like the region of Japan, so why is he here? And the Pokemon War, which is never really discussed, and it's kind of a mystery, but it's alluded to a lot in this game, and it just begs the question, were Pokemon really fighting a war? Maybe they were trying to do like a World War II kind of thing, or I don't know. I really think they were kind of alluding it to the Gulf War. I was guessing, yeah, Persian Gulf War. And that's why they added Lieutenant Surge, because that was around the time, so maybe they went with that route. But I don't know, I guess we'll never know. Why, I was overpowered. Alright, so we defeated Juggler. Let's see who this guy is. Looks like a gentleman. You're here to defeat Lieutenant Surge? Not if I can help it. If memory serves me correctly, this guy actually served with Lieutenant Surge in the war. I'm using like finger quotes there. Because like, what war was he? I just love how like even, I believe the sketch by, I forgot this comedian, but there was a sketch that had like, he interviews a ton of Street Fighter contestants like Ryu, Ken, and all them. And don't use double team spam, good. But yeah, he's up to interviewing Guile, and he asked him, yeah, it seems, I look at your resume here and it says you were in a war? What war was that? And Guile's like, the war. Because they don't even know like what war he was in, like he wasn't, by the time the interview's over, he's like, they pretty much deduce that he wasn't even in a war. He just thinks he was, so. I don't know, maybe it was with Lieutenant Surge and he's just posing as a freaking American. Kind of like in Yu-Gi-Oh, I believe, that guy named Keith. He poses out like an American, but he's really Canadian. I don't know, that'd be really funny if Lieutenant Surge wasn't even in a war. Sorry, sir! Lieutenant Surge, no! Let's find out. When I was still in the army, Lieutenant Surge saved my life. Man, Lieutenant Surge, like, he's only like 30 years old in this game? Lieutenant Surge recognized my potential with electric Pokemon. Think you beat me? So yeah, this war must have occurred very recently, or... It's weird how Lieutenant Surge saved that old man's life. Like, really? He was already Lieutenant past that old man? Wow. He must have been quite the soldier. And guitarist Vincent. Alright, let's rock his soul with Gar right here, because he's gonna do some nice work against this guy, and alright, level 27, back to the cannon fodder. Let's see how fast I can take this guy out. So yeah, I love how the guy in the beginning of this part said like, oh yeah, the gym leaders in this region are a nightmare. Yeah, we're gonna I think this region's only gonna be 10 parts, really, because we're just going to towns right now and just laying the wood on these guys. And we're just gonna freaking dominate because we're very, very overleveled and this will be a cakewalk. I don't know what they were, like, honestly, like, they expected the game, like, the person playing this game to beat the Leaf 4. Obviously, he's gonna be a high level, so why would they make these Pokemon such a low level? Like, I keep mentioning this, but HeartGold and SoulSilver fixed that problem, made the Pokemon, like, 10 levels higher. And let's see, Magnemite. It's actually pretty funny, too, because when we fight Brock in this, he's like level 40 with all his Pokemon, which raises the question, like, what if you started off your adventure in Palutown like normal, like in the original games, and you fight Brock and he's got like level 40 Pokemon? Does he like have crap Pokemon on the side that he pulls out against like novice trainers, and he only pulls out the good ones when he fights good trainers? I don't know how gym leaders do that. Maybe that's how they work in systems like that. Oh, how shocking. If anyone else uses a shocking pun in this, I'm gonna flip one of these trash cans. But nope, they're not active. And here we go. Lieutenant Surge, the Lightning American. Hey, you little tack. I have to hand it to you. It may not be very smart to challenge me, but it takes guts. When it comes to electric Pokemon, I'm number one. I've never lost on the battlefield. I'll zap you just like I did my enemies in the war. Oh man, and here is one of my favorite themes in the game, the remix version of the Kanto gym leader fights. Ah, oh, it's so good. And here's that ugly abomination Raichu he's gonna lead with. And hey, we're actually seeing Pokemon that are around our level. Awesome, so just the gym leaders are at our level. Alright, so this is actually gonna be a challenge. We're out of Boomerang, so we're gonna have to go with Bone Club here. And we're not gonna pull off one of those, are we? Alright, he misses quite a bit with his Bone Club. Like, come on, it's a fat orange mouse. How do you miss? The thing hasn't worked out in weeks. It's been out of service for a while now. Take it out. Alright, let's see if we can take it out here. And there we go. Nice. And let's just do that. And his first Pokemon is Dunzo. So let's see, sir, which is your next Pokemon? You got a Magneton Maggot? Okay. I'm surprised he wouldn't like nickname his Magneton Maggot. It just rolls off the tongue so well. Could have definitely played on those wordplay. Oh, come on! Accuracy is just abomination. I'll use abomination again. I already used that word. And of course, when he uses double team, we'll hit him. Like, Pokemon logic at its finest. Here we go. Magneton is down. And let's see, what else you got? And he's got five Pokemon, too. So, ooh, Electabuzz. Ooh. Electabuzz is one of my favorite Pokemon. I was bummed that I didn't get an Elekid in that egg that we got in the beginning of the game. We got a freaking, I don't know, what did we get, a Smoochum or a Magby? I don't know. It's a Pokemon obviously I didn't care much about, and this is level 46 too, so I was gonna say it's actually gonna face a challenge, or be a challenge, but nope, took it out in one shot. Now we're level 48 with our Marowak, and the last and final, or no, two more to go, sorry. Electrode, okay. We should be fine as long as it doesn't use self-destruct, but then again, it does have the speed advantage and an evasiveness advantage right now. And Bone Club, nice. And okay, another one-hit KO, so everything's been a one-hit KO. Guess we got a strong bone there in our hands. That did not sound right. Definitely could have phrased that better, but hey, he's got two electrodes, okay. You would think he would have like two Raichus or something, because that's his signature Pokemon, but nope. He's got two electrodes, and gonna make quick work of it like we did the one before it, and it is defeated. There we go, wipe that grin off its face, and there we go, our first gym badge of the Kanto region by defeating Lieutenant Surge. Car, you are strong! Okay, kid, you get Thunder Badge. Yankee received the Thunder Badge by being the best American he could be. Thunder Badge increases Pokemon's speed. Consider it proof that you defeated me. You wear it proudly here. You guys like a southern twine to that. Hey, kid, still slugging and chugging away? My Pokemon and I are still at it. Okay, so he's not going to give us a TM. Good riddance, though. Oh, you're not my friend. Alright, so we defeated Lieutenant Surge, and let's just cut this tree down and make our way to another town to vanquish another gym. But obviously we can't go that way, so yeah, unlike the last game in Gold and Blue, I keep making that freaking flub. But yeah, we're not going one by one, like 1 through 8, we're pretty much just bouncing around. So yeah, we start with Lieutenant Surge first, he's the third gym leader. So we're going to make our way, I think, to Saffron, or I think that we're making our way over there. So let's just pass these guys for now and just make our way to the next town. And let's see, this guy's blocking the way. Road's closed until the problem with the power plant is solved, okay. Problems at the power plant. Call Lieutenant Surge on the job, he's a freaking electrician, for Christ's sake. Maybe not an electrician, but a master of electric Pokemon. And does this guy need water? No, he does not. Welcome to Saffron City, home of the Magnet Train. That's what I'd normally say, but the Magnet Train isn't running now. It's not getting any electricity because there's something wrong with the power plant. I guess there is, because everyone's mentioning it. And here we go, we are at Saffron City, but I just remembered that we forgot to do something in Vermilion City that I was gonna do, but I forgot. It's actually gonna do it in the beginning of the part, but hey, we'll just head back right now and just retrace our steps. I just wanted to step foot into Saffron so we could just fly there now. Save a couple of seconds there, and what we want to do is actually enter this building, which is, of course, the famous Pokemon Fan Club. Well, Pokemon fans, welcome. Alright, so here we go. It's a Clefairy, huh? Oh, right, it's a Clefairy Pokedoll. Wow, this guy couldn't get his own Pokemon, so he just has a doll here. I guess he must be really that big of a fan. I love the way Clefairy wiggles his finger when it tries to use Metronome. It's so adorable. Too bad I can never catch one, just like just a tear, single tear goes down his eye. Look at my darling bay leaf. The leaf on its head is so cute. I'm really a bay leaf here, okay. Our chairman is very vocal when it comes to Pokemon. Yes, he is. Let's all listen to other trainers. What other code of conduct? If someone brags, brag right back. What? I don't think that's the right thing to teach kids. That's a terrible message. Oh man, so anyway, let's talk to this guy. I'm the chairman of the Pokemon Fan Club. I've raised over 150 Pokemon, very fussy when it comes to Pokemon. Did you visit just to hear about my Pokemon? Yes. Good, then listen up. So my favorite Rapidash. It's cute, lovely, smart, unbearable, plus amazing. Oh, you think so? Too much, wild, beautiful, kindly, love it. So wow, dog. I just think of the doggy meme. Wow, so beautiful, so bright, so great, kindly. All these random words, hug it, when, sleeping, warm, and cuddly, oh, and spectacular. I'm doing a William Shatner. Okay, sounds like an Italian William Shatner. Ravishing, simply divine. Oops, look at the time, I've kept you too long. Thanks for hearing me out, I want you to have this. And he gave us a rare candy, but the item pocket's full. Our item pocket is full. And there we go, give me my rare candy. I would have definitely taken that bike voucher, because that's pretty much worth $1 million. Really? Did you give me the explanation of the rare candy? kind of beat the Pokemon League already. I kind of know what that is. Game's teaching me things already. They're teaching me things I already know. Alright, so let's just fly on over to Saffron City, and then we'll call it a part. So, in the next part, we'll explore Saffron City and maybe take on the gym leader that resides here. I remember she was pretty tough in the original, so I'll see you later, guys, and until next time on Let's Play Pokemon Crystal.